Hello friends of the Northern Entertainment, and welcome to another episode of my ATS Let's Play series. It's been a while that we had the chance to share the wide virtual roads together. So I figured why not, after tonight's stream, which was fairly well visited and watched. So we are taking this VNL 670. Facebook, yeah. And we are taking our load down to Grand Canyon bitumen. Machine parts, 9 tons of it. So it's not a super heavy load, which is good, because this is not a super powerful truck, and we are still a company driver. Looks like it's a little bit of a busy day. This is, by the way, the rescaled version of the vanilla map, which is why I have no mod whatsoever. I'm running my usual mods, namely... Namely, the realistic graphics, advanced headlights, or not advanced headlights, but what is it called now? Realistic headlights. Then, of course, I'm running 128 different trailer packs, or different standalone trailers, I should say. And we are coming out here out of Las Vegas. Yeah, as I said, going down from Las Vegas to Grand Canyon. Hopefully we're gonna see a little bit of the rescaled map. It's not a super long run, but I figured to get our feet wet again, it is just perfect. Not the greatest weather here that we see. And as you can clearly see here, just as we are driving under Mandalay Place, Palace, sorry, it is indeed a little bit of an overcast day. Hopefully we'll make it through the city okay, because, well, it is one of those days where you have a lot of traffic. And we gotta make a mile today. We gotta make a mile, because the new truck won't pay itself. But yeah, guys, pretty amazing things on my channel that are lately happening. Of course, emergency call 112 is was pretty crazy. The same with Farming Simulator. The support that you guys showed me there was absolutely overwhelming and very humbling. I did not think that we would be already looking at... that we would be already looking at 60,000 by the end of November, but lo and behold, less than 120 to go by the time of this recording. And if you hear the switches in the background, let me know if they are annoying to you or not, because I can leave that in or I can take it out. The music that you hear comes out of the radio in the truck, of course with my own MP3s, so Well, you guys know how that works. I do think we are getting here fairly clean through the city. We should be here on the highway right away. Over the speed limit, but I'm not going to completely break it. Outdoor world, yep. Drive carefully and come back. Oh, we will do that. Oh, Pizza Hut. Nom nom nom. So if you have ATS, let me know what you think for about the rescale so far, if you had already a chance. If you have ATS and you have not tried the rescale and you don't know how, it is... somebody didn't pay attention there. I have to say, from what I've seen so far of this, it's quite quite nice. The flow of the map is just way better, as far as I'm concerned. Just flows nicer. And we are in Arizona. One of the things that changed was that if you come up to a scale, they will tell you now, well ahead of time, whether or not they want to see you or not. So that, as far as I'm concerned, is a nice little touch. Okay, so apparently 10 gears and that's it. Well, I mean, we are in 5 high and we are at 65 miles an hour, so that's not bad. It is nice to see with the rescale. I am going to, or I am contemplating of doing a run with the normal map and then doing the same run on the rescale and just see how much longer it takes. But for that, of course, you have to have twice the same load, so that, of course, could prove to be a little bit of a problem. But quite a nice drive, I have to say. I do enjoy it. And it's good for multiplayer as well, of course, because everything gets a little bit more, pulled apart, so to speak. And I have to say, there are a little bit more challenging hills and valleys now that you drive through. I noticed that already. Brake killers, we call them. Oh yeah, I'm also Canadian, eh? Okay, here we go. Yep, there it is, everybody. Loaded, empty. Well, we are definitely loaded. ~26 tons gross. Well, that's not too bad. He's letting us. That's nice of him. Better get over because it looks like a busy day. Yep. A very busy day indeed. Yeah. Well, that's just the thing, right? You never know what you get in, what you get yourself into when you come into the cities. I mean, you can make good time all day long on the highways, and then next thing you know is you are sitting at a red light for 15 minutes because the traffic is just atrocious and you just won't make it through. But it looks like we are pretty close to our destination anyway, which is, man, a nice 20-minute drive. This is not too bad. I hope that I still have you guys with me, yeah? Maybe we can get a nice shot here of the traffic situation. Oh boy. It is one of those days, is it? I probably can't even make it through the intersection without locking everything. Oh no, we're good, I think. Well, for what it's worth, we made it over the intersection and almost cleared it too. I think, yeah, we are clear. That's more than you can say of the vehicle behind us, I guess, but could pull a little bit ahead just because then he can pull off the intersection. Yeah, he's lucky, he's gonna make it through. I, on the other hand, ain't that lucky. That's all good. You know, not getting all excited in traffic, this is one thing that I learned when I was driving a real truck. And you know, in a way, the AI traffic is not much different. There's people that get all excited and start yelling and whatnot. What for, really? I mean, think about that. You have... You're gonna be on the road one way or the other. And you can be... Either you are on the road and you're gonna be miserable. And you're gonna be yelling at everybody. Thanks, buddy, there. Or... You just say, you know what? I just take my time and... do what needs to be done. I don't know, I personally, I just think life is way too short to get excited about things like that. Especially on a game. And we are already here, or almost in... Kingman, which is where we have to deliver. Oh no, that's not true. We are delivering in no, CR England with a brand new trailer. Look at that. There you go. See, just like that, dude. I mean, I could have just kept my line there and leave him, or yeah, make him slam the brakes and whatnot, cause all kinds of grief. He's angry at me, I'm angry at him. Instead, you lift your foot, maybe tap the brakes a little bit and let him in. He can get on his way because he's faster than we are anyway. And oh, what a sunset though. That's what I'm talking about. Look at that sunset in the rearview mirror. My goodness, beautiful. UPS is chasing FedEx, that's funny. I don't know, sunsets always, and sunsets and sunrises, just those are the moments where you really love to be on the road, because the things that you see sometimes when you come over the highway, come around the mountain or whatever, and then you just see one breathtaking sunset or one really breathtaking sunrise, that really, it sets the tone for the whole next day, as far as I'm concerned. And even in a game, it can be still very, very much so magnificent when you see that. And for those of you that are new to the Northern Pack, please say hello. Because there's so many new faces that watch my videos lately, and I would like to see... I mean, of course I appreciate my old fans that are with me since, yeah, whatever, for a long time. But I also want to see who's new, and I want to hear from you guys, and I want to read from you guys. And when we share here this time in the cab of the truck, I mean, yeah, of course it's just virtual and it's just a game and all these things. But still, I mean, you and I, we sit here together in this virtual truck and we're gonna run down the virtual highways, and it's just, well, it's nice. I enjoy it. And now that we have this rescale, it might really rekindle my love for the game, because it was just... You can only run over the same highway so many times. So our hopes are that now that they have the rescale... Well, now of course this is just a beta and we have to wait up till we get the full release, but once the full release is done, I really, really hope that the process of new map making is a little bit sped up. But I guess we'll have to wait and see. Now, do I have to get over or not? Not 100% sure. Flagstaff, Hallbrook. I guess we'll find out here in about 2 seconds. Nope. Is he standing or is he turning off? He must be turning off. Oh boy. Looks like we are climbing a little bit here. Make the old Volvo work for his money. I was a little bit off with my prediction of how long this run is going to be. That's going to be a good sized episode, I think. Which I think is really, really nice. I don't know about you guys, but I'm happy about that. Oh, I think this is one of the remodeled intersections. So here we come up and over and back on the highway. are coming here through Flagstaff right away, so I better slow on down. And it looks like exactly what I was hoping for is indeed the case. We don't have those ridiculous going from going from 65 miles to 25 miles in one swift motion. It is a little bit more gradual. So, buddy from roadway ahead of us. Very, very nice. How's my fuel doing? Ah, yeah, we have enough. Oh my, what is this? Walmart? Huh? No sales tax. Well then. I have to admit, that was one of the things that I had to learn. I mean, a lot of things were not new to me when I came to Canada originally, but one of the things that I had to learn, and I learned that the hard way, was how the how the sales tax is added after the fact. Like when you have something on the shelf and it says it's $5.30, how you still have to add the sales tax to that. Because in Europe, for example, you have whatever is on the sign is what the product will actually cost. Oh wow. By the way, guys, did you notice that the reflective stripes are now actually only reflective when there's light on them and not always? That is quite nice, because that was something that kind of bothered me a little bit, was the fact that the fact that when you would drive and even though there was absolutely nothing illuminating the reflective stripes, they would be bright as day. And now reflective stripes earn their name because they are actually reflecting, which is nice. You know, it's those little things that always make a difference as far as I'm concerned. That is a nice road here. I like that. See, as we come now up to him, the reflective stripes start reflecting, just as the name should suggest. And bitumen is up there, which is where we have to go, so... This episode is now unfortunately coming to an end. But I guess we'll see where we have to park. Oh, over there, okay. Perfect. And turn that on. Hopefully our backup lights deserve the name today. This rearview mirror on the other side is so ridiculously small always. It's a little bit annoying. But I think we have a pretty good approach here. Let me straighten out before we completely loop. Yeah, this is a nice approach here, in fact. Good, 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 good. Alright, load is ready for unloading. Let's have a last look at this unit. Because this truck we will not drive anymore. As I said, this is just a company truck. So, I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, then please hit that like button. Leave a comment down below if you feel inclined to do so. And thank you so much for watching, guys. Thanks for all the support. And I hope to talk to you guys very, very soon. This is the Northern Alex signing off. God bless.